Hey, this is Jeff. Welcome back to Coito Ergo Sum, Let's Talk More Action, a series which is all about the Benjamins. Usually. I see George Washington and Abraham Lincoln in my wallet a lot more than Benjamin Franklin, so let's say this one's about dead presidents. Last week, Courier Jeff ran around the Mojave frantically doing photo shoots with NCR Rangers because he was warned if he keeps working with Yes Man to establish an independent state in New Vegas, the NCR will declare him persona non grata.
How are you doing today,
Rondo? And I want to make a movie before Leah goes back to California, but when Fresca's using the studio, it isn't available for photo shoots. But since then, I realized it doesn't matter if I get locked out of personally recruiting NCR soldiers as models because we'll eventually be able to hire a staff photographer whose reputation is so solid she can convince anybody to pose. Anyway, we just need to talk to Hilly before we start casting.
Hey, sweetie.
Oh, I just love...
Well, if it ain't my favorite mover and shaker.
We're almost ready to make holovids.
I was starting to wonder if you was ever going to get that done.
And I don't mind doing this before I buy out his shares because this was my project all the way. There's no fair reason I should give you a cut.
Now hold on. That wasn't our deal.
The deal was, hookers use your beds, the magazine uses your press, but the video is all me.
Don't forget, it is my studio.
Okay, it's your building. I'll give you 100 caps per shoot to rent the studio.
Well, I reckon I can live with that. At least I'm not liable for your debts if you start losing money.
And now we're ready to start casting. Not to throw salt on the wound, but how would you like to be in a porno movie? Actors get 300 caps.
You shitting me? Hell yeah!
Love to see a pretty young smooth skin like yourself. I hope you like it here.
Tammy's about as smooth skin as it gets.
Later, dude.
Caradom.
What's up, Hefe?
Want to make a video? It pays 300 caps, and I think Fresca would love working with you.
If what I've read is true, I'm going to love working with her. I'll go down to the studio and get ready.
Oh, where's Rondo?
It's been kind of slow, baby. Need some help with marketing?
I didn't check the finances on the terminal today, but the employees occasionally make comments like that if you're losing a lot of money, so that's a good sign. Anyway, Rondo, you don't need to worry about the saloon. It's going to get worse before it gets better, but it will get better. And with our recent acquisition, Lollipops is all the way back. Want to make a video? It pays 300 caps.
You never cease to amaze me, baby. We'll give Golden Globes a run for their money. I'll go down to the studio and get ready.
Now, even though the first few actors I'm hiring were pretty convenient, I'm not just asking the first people I see. I have a very specific plan to make a movie I think will sell the maximum number of copies possible. And of course, the keystone to my plan is Leah, which is why the last couple weeks have been so focused on getting the Holovid quest going before she has her baby.
Hello, doctor. How's the patient?
You're both fine. Whatever you're doing, keep it up.
Who would have guessed that hand-rolled cigarettes and jet orgies would be good for a baby? I'm kidding. What, I'm rich, so I'm not allowed to have a sense of humor?
I don't know how complicated this would be, but here's an enhancement idea. If you're Leah's doctor, when you examine her, you could get an estimate of her due date. I mean, it could still be off by some random amount, but at least you'd know if you were looking at weeks or hours. I don't know. Maybe that's not realistic. When you meet her, she says 2 weeks, and she can be up to a week early or a week late. Maybe that's as accurate as you can reasonably expect. My knowledge of obstetrics is appallingly thin. Like, I didn't know this until I looked it up during the old walkthrough, but doctors say that unless there are specific complicating factors, it's generally safe to have sex right up until your water breaks. Maybe everybody knew that but me, but I just wanted to make sure I wasn't asking her to do something dangerous. Since I'm not, I bet a photo shoot was just an appetizer for a sex maniac like you. How about doing a porno movie?
Well, I'm tired, but I'm so horny I could hump a customer.
Anyway, holovid sales are partially based on the same things as magazine sales. Which would make more sense if I had ever published a magazine and explained how that worked, but bear with me. NPCs have three attributes that influence magazine and holovid sales: appearance, appeal, and attitude. Setting a magazine layout is almost like a minigame where you match the model's attributes with the magazine section that needs a particular attribute, and it works the same for male and female models. Holovids don't have a layout because Fresca writes the script, and the sales are mainly based on the sum of the actress's bonuses. The male actor's appeal, appearance, and attitude aren't counted, but they have different perks that can boost certain scores for the actresses, or directly increase sales or a couple of other effects. So for example, anybody who stars with Hilly gets a +1 appearance bonus because he makes them look more attractive by comparison. Rondo gives his co-stars a +1 appeal bonus because his charisma rubs off on them. So Maria, who's in the middle tier for all three attributes, gets bumped to the top tier of appearance by Hilly and the top tier of appeal by Rondo. Leah's already in the top tier of appearance and appeal, but like Maria, she's in the middle tier of attitude. So our next priority is to find an actor who can boost their attitude bonus. I'm probably going to take a few stings if I run through here, but I'm not stopping to kill them all. Yep. Anyway, Cara Dom would work for the attitude bonus because his pre-war porn star technique drives his co-stars crazy in bed, but I have somebody else in mind who brings even more to the party. Literally. And by the way, there's a list of all the NPCs who can be recruited as movie stars, along with their bonuses and perks, in the walkthroughs and hints document that you can download from the Nexus page for the mod. I assume the Cazadores gave up by now. Looks like it. They don't wander too far from their nests. So my next stop is a visit to my neighbors in Red Rock Canyon, and I might as well drop in and see the armorer while I'm passing by to top up my 308 ammo. She had the motherload this time, over 200 rounds of normal 308 and almost 100 rounds each of hollow points and armor piercing. So, back to casting, this is actually a twofer, because Jack and Diane will only be in a movie with each other. Diane is one of only, I think, 4 or 5 NPCs in the whole game who's in the top tier of everything, appearance, appeal, and attitude, so of course I want her to be in it. And Jack gives everybody else a +1 attitude bonus because he's a chemist, and he brings mood enhancers to loosen everybody up. Anders, what were you doing in Jack and Diane's trailer? They may already be warmed up.
Hey, what's up?
Would you and Diane like to be in a porno movie?
Seriously. Hey, groovy.
The director might ask you to do scenes with other people. Is that okay?
It's cool, man. Me and Diane, as long as we got each other, we don't care who we roll with.
You can ask either one of them and they both teleport to the studio. I think Diane's dialogue is actually more interesting, but I did
those
that...
Those black-armored devils might be new to the Mojave, but they're butchers like all the rest.
Damn it, CR. I'll give Belthin a link to put in the description if you want to see Diane's dialogue. And our last actress is Dazzle, who's in the top tier of appearance, middle tier appeal and attitude, but with Rondo and Jack, she'll be in the top tier of everything.
Back again. Did you miss me?
I'm shooting a movie at Lollipops. It pays 300 caps. Do the rules say you can only screw here?
Well, just don't tell anyone. Come on, let's go.
So now we just need one more actor, and we already have enough actor perks to bump all the actresses to their maximum bonuses. We saw last week the player character can be in the movies. A female courier gets the same appearance, appeal, and attitude bonuses that you get for the magazine, but a male courier doesn't apply any perks. You just get that sense of accomplishment that comes from a fade-to-black cutscene that implies you might have had sex with a character who isn't otherwise romanceable. In this case, you can have sex with Dazzle in the vanilla game.
Those freeside thugs aren't worth our time anymore.
You can have sex with Maria anytime after you hire her. Fresca would probably pair Diane with Jack, and it would be inappropriate to have sex with Leah since I'm her doctor. More importantly, I'm trying to maximize my profit, and there are still a few actors with perks that can bump that up even more.
Oh, it's you again. What is it?
Oh, that's not good. There are a few characters like Leah who will only be in a movie if they've already been in the magazine, and apparently Bruce is one of them. That's a shame because he's so famous that a movie gets a bonus just from him being in it. Oh, goodbye.
Yeah. See you later.
Welp, plan B.
Well, if it isn't my number one fan, what can I do for you, number one fan?
Just kidding. Glad the new job's working out for you. Gotta roll.
Yeah, go on. Scram.
I hope Swank's smarter than Benny.
Well, well, well. If it ain't the best love cat on the strip in my theater, what could Tommy do for you, baby?
Unfortunately, Tommy isn't even recruitable. Hopefully he'll be added in a future update. Goodbye.
Take it easy, baby.
Well, the next best thing to somebody who is directly boosting sales is somebody who works free. I forget the exact profit per unit sold, but the standard 300 cap salary is nothing to sneeze at.
That's the guy who killed Caesar.
Yep, that's me. I'm also the guy who killed Benny, which is why they don't confiscate my weapons when I come in anymore. Anyway, I guess we'll head back to Lollipops. Oh, there's JT.
What's up?
He can be in a movie too, and he gives a plus one attitude bonus to his co-stars for the same reason as Jack, but the actresses are already maxed in that, so hiring him now would just be throwing away 300 caps. But I do want to see what you have for sale.
Step into my office.
Can never have too many hand-rolled cigarettes.
Enjoy.
See ya.
Happy trails.
One of these days I'm gonna have to do something about these things. Which you actually can after you start upgrading the saloon, but I'm not doing any of that until I get rid of Hilly. In the vanilla game, there's not much reason to come through here unless you want to farm XP, and even with Coito Ergo Sum, in normal mode I just fast travel around them, but in hardcore mode, not wanting to fast travel, I just have to kill them every time they respawn. Why is there an undiscovered location on my compass? Son of a monkey. The last one gets me and makes me waste antivenom. Hello? Okay. It must be the makeshift Great Khan camp, but I can't believe I've never been there. Yep. Well, I guess I shouldn't be that surprised. Until I installed Coito Ergo Sum, I avoided this area like the plague. That wasn't a Cazador. I think it was a giant scorpion, which would be a long way from home for them, but whatever. They're dangerous, but not nearly as annoying as cazadores. Yeah, I'm glad the armorer had a full stock, because 50 rounds later, I'm still not home. I should be able to sneak past the rest of them, though, so could have been worse. While we're here, let's check out the rehearsals. Apparently, Diane's playing a hooker. Fresca's working on this script or something.
So, you've been sucked into the decadence of the strip as well, have you?
Their costumes and the lines they practice are actually different if you tell Fresca to go for a pro-NCR or anti-NCR theme. I told her to use her judgment, so they're just the classic porn everybody is horny all the time motif.
Hello, doctor. How's the patient?
You're fine. Enjoy.
Thanks. I'll see you later.
I'm really busy now. Sorry.
I thought this was about fucking. Nobody said nothing about memorizing. I gotta rehearse.
Leah, one thing. If Jack offers you anything stronger than whatever a person with my medicine skill would know is safe for a pregnant mother, just say no. Definitely no jet. Anyway, I'm going to go home for some food, water, and sleep before I recruit the last actor, who, as it happens, lives in Pahrump. There are actually two characters in Pahrump who can be in movies. Fire and Rain, who's kind of, I don't know, independent? She doesn't really seem to care about social norms, even in a place as relaxed as Pahrump. With the right co-star, she can be a pretty decent addition to the cast. And Coyote, who... how shall I put this? If you're ever trying to find him at night and he isn't in the garage, check the houses of the single women in town, and he'll probably be in one of them. I've seen him sleeping with Fire and Rain, Syandra, Perry, probably others. Fortunately, it's the middle of the day, so he should be working in the junkyard.
Hey man, how's it hanging?
Being so isolated here in the valley, do you know what a porno movie is?
Believe it or not, I've actually seen one. When we were kids, Mole Rats found a video player in one of the old houses in the South End. He got it working and we watched some westerns. There were romances too. I think he eventually gave it to Saffron when she was into Jane Austen.
Romances aren't porn. Well, not Victorian romances, anyway.
I know. The normal movies were on a shelf in the living room, but there were others about people making babies, all stuffed into the back of a drawer. We assumed it was because most of them just weren't very good. But Mom explained it later. She wasn't born in the valley, you know.
What did your mother tell you about porno movies?
She said pre-war people were embarrassed by sex, which sounds pretty dumb, but we are talking about people who had a nuclear war, so yeah.
Do you think any of the other houses have video players?
No, I cleaned them all out looking for vacuum tubes.
Do you still have the video players you salvaged?
Yeah, they're somewhere in the shop, but they don't work.
Could you get the video players in your shop working again?
I doubt it. I'm okay with generators and terminals and things that were designed to be reliable, which consumer electronics were not.
Two Mole Rats repaired a video player once. Could he do it again?
Well, that was a long time ago, but maybe. If he's not too busy being mayor, it couldn't hurt to ask him.
Well, I'm making new videos. Would you like to be in one yourself?
You mean record me having sex with women who are really good at it? You bet I will.
Actually, I think I already asked two mole rats about Holovid players. Yeah, because I was surprised that dialogue was unlocked already. Yeah, let's talk to him. And our next objective is to tell Fresca the cast is set, so we'll do that as soon as we talk to two mole rats. There he is.
How's it going?
How's the Holovid player coming?
Here you go. I have enough parts to make another if you want to check back in a few days.
Goodbye.
Until we meet again.
Having him make Holovid players is actually optional. Once we have the finished product, we'll need to set up a distribution deal to sell them. But since there aren't that many working Holovid players left in the world, we just get a little more money for each one two mole rats fixes up. So let's go tell Fresca she can start filming. Well, technically taping, I guess. Where is she? Oh, she's over there.
Perhaps you should remove your dress, Miss Blototsky. I don't think the First Lady believed that was a mayonnaise stain last week. Oh my.
Whoa. I don't think I've ever seen one that big before.
Hey, it's the hottest producer in Vegas. What's happening?
The cast is complete.
We're almost ready to start shooting. It's a closed set, and there really isn't much for a producer to do at this point in the process.
Can I stay and watch?
It's not as fun as it sounds, and I'm not going to cut for a water break every 5 minutes. When we're done, maybe you can help with editing and post-production. We can have it ready for duplication in a week or so.
Then I'll just get out of your hair?
Okay, we'll probably be in here the better part of a day, and I'll need a few more for editing and titles, that kind of thing. Call it a week before it's ready for distribution. Once you see the master print, you can run as many as you want through the duplication deck.
And now when we leave, the door locks behind us so we can't see what's going on in there. If you use the console to toggle clipping, they just stand around the same as they do in rehearsal. Which I only know because I like to be thorough in my research for these walkthroughs, not because I'm a pervert or anything. And I've been wondering why my carry weight is so high. I've been carrying around the blank holotapes from the Slater Mansion for 2 weeks, so stash those. And of course, I forgot to stop at the house before I recruited Coyote. So back to Pawrump again. In fact, that's not the worst thing in the world because I have a bunch more blank holotapes stored there from Cytogenesis. Did I find some of them somewhere else? Doesn't matter, they're all in my desk. I can pick them up while I'm there. I'll pick this maze, it's ready. Always welcome. And since Fresca will be shooting the movie for the better part of a day and editing for a couple days after that, we have plenty of time to see if Yes Man has anything interesting for us to do. So we'll do that as soon as we get topped up here.
An entire army of upgraded Securitrons just standing by over at the fort. Pretty neat, huh?
Absolutely. Let's talk about the tribes I should get to know.
Please, go on.
Oh, I hope this isn't going to be a problem. You don't have to do much more than visit Gamora to be able to tell Yes Man you want the Emeritus left alone, but once you tell him, you're locked out of the quests to do the actual investigation. Which I don't actually care about, but I was planning to have Joanna star in a future movie, and I know there are certain conditions under which she disappears from the game. Hopefully this isn't one of them. You can leave the Emeritus alone.
You got it! I won't say another word about them. That accounts for all the tribes you needed to get to know. You did a super job wrapping things up, and I'm not just saying that because I have to. Here's some big news. I decoded a military radio transmission, and it turns out the NCR president, Aaron Kimball, is going to visit Hoover Dam. I guess he wants to boost the troop's morale. But according to projections Mr. House made, he has an 83.75% chance of being assassinated.
Oops.
Anyway, it looks like Mr. House thought it was important to keep President Kimball alive.
Why?
Mr. House ran projections on how the NCR public will react to a defeat at Hoover Dam. Overwhelmingly, they'll blame Kimball. But if Kimball dies at Hoover Dam, there's no obvious scapegoat for them to blame, so they'll blame New Vegas instead. So that means reduced tourism for up to 5 years. The equations are pretty complicated. Mr. House sure liked numbers.
I'm on good terms with the NCR. They'll let me help protect him. Well, I am for the moment. I don't know how long that's going to last, but see what happens.
Great. A ranger named Graham has been placed in charge of security for the president's visit.
Graham?
You'll want to talk to him. Once the president is safe, there's one more thing for you to take care of. This gadget I'm handing you is called an override module. Mr. House had two of these made years and years ago. Just like him to think ahead. Take the module to the El Dorado substation and attach it to the power control terminal. I'll handle the rest.
All right, I'll be on my way.
Be careful out there. It won't be long before the Legion makes its move.
Well, they'll be doing it without Kaisar. Yeah, NCR infamy. Failed for the Republic, so I don't know if they'll actually accept my help at the dam or not. But guess we'll find out. Yeah, I'm still idolized. Well, one way to find out.
I've heard of you. I'm glad you're here to help us out. This is a delicate matter, and we need all the help we can get from people we can trust. We've got a lot to do to prepare for the president's visit, and not much time. Once we start, we'll be on a strict timetable. Are you ready?
I'm all set.
Good. The president doesn't arrive until tomorrow. Get some rest. I'll brief you in the morning.
Yeah, that's what I thought. His name is Grant, so Yes Man's intelligence is suspect.
Glad you could join us. Most of my men are already on duty, and the crowd has already started gathering outside. We've got a busy day ahead of us.
Let's get this show on the road.
President Kimball is arriving shortly. If you want to do any last-minute security sweeps or take a look around for anything suspicious, do it now. Once you're ready, meet me outside on the observation deck. But don't take too long.
All right. Yes Man claims it's important to my profits to keep this guy alive, so we're going to do a thorough job of investigating.
Wish I could have been there to see Caesar die. What an asshole. Hey, I heard about you. What can I do for you, friend?
Nice looking dog you have there.
Thanks. We haven't been paired together long, but he's a smart dog.
How do you get his coat so shiny?
I brush it every day. 100 brushes.
Looks like you have it under control. Goodbye.
Bye.
Maybe you should cut back to 50 brushes a day, because I've seen ghouls that look better than that dog. Okay, they have a sentry up there. Good thinking.
Only engineers and authorized personnel are allowed upstairs. Please step away.
Well, with someone like you on guard, I'm sure there's no way anyone could sabotage the president's vertibird.
Have you finished your security sweep?
I'm ready. When will the president be here?
Looks like that's his vertibird coming right now. It's showtime. Let's not mess this up. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got some security procedures to oversee.
And there it is. I love these things. Apparently, I'm not going anywhere for a while. Nice day for it! Did a dude just fall off that tower? Oh man, look at that gun. That thing is huge. Oh, I gotta take a look at that. What's pointing at? Legion Fort is over there. I think they just bombed the crap out of that. Maybe it doesn't work anymore. And his mother, like many Californians, braved the ruins of the old world as a prospector. They suffered through water shortages, raider attacks, and a brotherhood war. Oopsie. Like our mighty Sierra Nevadas, they endured. But the time came when they could no longer shoulder the burden alone. 12 years ago, they called out for help. And the Republic heard of them. Troopers, rangers just like you, answered the clarion call. I think it's pointing at the Deathclaw Sanctuary. Would have been nice if you shelled that place before I went up there. We made true on our promise, driving out the raider tribes to establish a lasting peace in the eastern Sierra Nevada. There's the vertibird. Those things are so cool. And we will find many of our brothers and sisters on that battlefield. It did not break us. Nah, there's a dude up there. Apparently I was tripping balls. Man, how long can this guy talk? Sometimes we forget that the light of our society shines beyond our borders. Sometimes we take those privileges for granted that our forebears fought so hard to achieve. We must always remember that wherever Californians stand, we carry our principles with us. Look, man, I'm completely on board with the men and women this dick is pretending to respect, but he's exploiting their sacrifices to justify expanding the NCR by invading sovereign territory and wiping out indigenous people, and I am not on board with that. We are the heirs of that civilization. Torturers eastward of the Pacific, into the darkness of this wasted land. When the Republic called on the men and women of California to carry that fire across the Mojave, Jeremy Watson answered. He took the greatest risk. Not only for his fellow Californians, but for California itself. Do you mind? He was prepared to make the most noble of sacrifices to defend the principles of our Republic, even here, on Nevada soil. His actions are a beacon to all of us who stand here today in tribute to his valor. Private First Class Jeremy Watson, on behalf of the Senate and people of the new California Republic, it is my honor to present you with the Star of Sierra Madre. Not far from this spot, a monument stands as a tribute. Whoa! Oh boy. I think I'm just going to leave quietly before they start pointing fingers. I made sure the patrol dogs were ready. I checked security on the landing platform. I kept an eye on that suspicious engineer. And when Kimball got shot, the Rangers didn't even flinch like they knew it was coming. grassy knoll, yo. But you think they're going to take the blame? No. I'm the private security contractor, so it's going to be my fault. For the record, I didn't intentionally time the episode so that quest coincided with the President's Day holiday in the US, but once I realized it was coming up, I had to do it today. Anyway, I think I've probably whacked the hornet's nest more than is wise already, so I'm going to call it a day, and we can talk to Fresca about post-production stuff next week. See you then.